Hey guys, it's Jenna and John Sal from Elevation Worship, and we just wanted to take a minute just to encourage you as you're getting prepared and as you're already in the thick of it, as you're leading your teams during such a challenging time in our lives. We just wanted to encourage you with a verse. I love the verse in 1 Corinthians 4. This is the Message version that says, "You already have all that you need. You already have more access to God than you can handle." And I hope you're reminded of that today, that you already have all that you need. God's prepared That's you. Right. Yeah. He's positioned you to be the minister, to be the leader that you need to be in this season. He's given you a grace for this season to lead. And I pray that you're just reminded and you stay connected to the source so you can be obedient
yeah.
to His Holy Spirit and how He wants you to lead, how He wants you to minister, how He wants you to pastor your people. We love you. We're praying for yes. you. We're standing with you. We're all in this together. And we just pray that the Lord will just continue to fill your hearts with peace, with hope, and the assurance that you already have all that you need. Rest in that today.
Hey, what's up, fellow worship leaders? Torin Wells here, and I am headed in today to record services for this weekend. I'll be leading worship, as many of you will be, to an empty room. I think it's a great time to recalibrate why we lead and how we do it. Not as to entertain people in the room, but to entertain the presence of God. So bring the energy, bring the fire, know that you are connecting with people, but ultimately this is an opportunity for you to connect with Jesus and to create a space that other people can enter into and experience the overflow of that. So be encouraged this weekend, man. Lead strong, and my prayers are with you.
Hey everyone, it's Judd from Vertical Worship, and I just wanted to offer you some encouragement in this crazy, insane time that we're all living in. A thought that's been going on in my mind that I hope is encouraging to you is that we have the choice to either know what we feel, which is stressed, anxious, scared. I mean, it's a crazy time. Or we can feel what we know. And what we know is that God is for us. God is moving. He's working in this time. The heart of heaven is one of healing and of grace and mercy. And so I'm trying to feel what I know rather than just knowing what I feel, because I know that I feel anxious and I know that I feel worried for a lot of people. But I also know that the heart of God is chasing us this entire time, that He is working in ways that we could have never even imagined. So during this time, just seek the heart of God to know that His heart is for us and not against us, that He is working and moving in ways that we could never think or imagine, just like His word says. Just be encouraged in this time. God is for us.
Hey guys, Sarah Buchanan here. Just coming in with a quick word of encouragement. I know that our Sunday sets are looking really different right now, and there's a lot less people and a lot more you on a stage, perhaps. Maybe some cameras are going, and it feels really, really different and just not something you're used to. But I'm just popping in to give you some encouragement that this is actually where all the good stuff can really, really happen. You finally get a chance to lead people to the Lord in a way that feels so personal, right? Because you're stripping away a stage, you're stripping away everything on Sunday that kind of gets to you, and you're sitting there with yourself, your guitar, your instrument, your voice, and your God. What's cooler than that? I can't imagine anything cooler than just being in a room with you and your Father and knowing that that's enough and knowing that that is going to speak to the masses in its own special way. So, well, I wanted to read one more thing to you from Ephesians 3, where it says, "I pray that He may grant you, according to the riches of His glory, to be strengthened with power in your inner being through His Spirit, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. I pray that you, being rooted and firmly established in love, may be able to comprehend with all the saints what is the length and width, height and depth of God's love. May these weekends of uncertainty really breed a new level of faith and a new level of courage in you. And I pray that the Spirit would meet you right where you are. So get out there, show them what you're made of, and remember the God you serve is not one of man, but of the Creator of the universe. And that is really cool."
Hey guys, this is Corey from Red Rocks Worship. I just wanted to drop by real quick and encourage you and remind you that you're not alone. I am currently in my house as most of you are, we're kind of quarantined here. We're living day to day, hour to hour news updates. And I think that can cause a lot of tension, and it can cause a lot of questions and panic and hopelessness. But I wanted to remind you today, and John chapter 16, verse 33, Jesus said that I've taught you all of these things so that there could be a peace that lives inside of us. And then he said, you will face trials. You will go into seasons of tension. You will go into seasons of questions, but don't fear. Be courageous. Take heart, because I've already overcome the world. You know, the reality is a lot of our world is searching for hope. I have family members that don't know Jesus yet, and they're searching. They're looking for some sort of answer, some sort of hope right now. And the cool thing about the church is that he's given us that answer. He's given us this hope. And we need to be the first responders. So I want to encourage you, remember who God is. Remember who he's proven himself to be time and time again, and who he said he will be in the future. You are held. You are sheltered. You have a hope that cannot be taken by anything on this world. So stand strong. Be courageous. Take heart. He has already overcome the world. Talk to you guys.
Hello, beloved. I hope that this message finds you well. We're in strange times, but they're not surprising times, because Jesus told us we would be here. Jesus told us we would be here. He said to fear not, because he's overcome all of it. So be encouraged that this will pass. This will all pass. He is forever. All of this is fleeting, even though it feels like a lot right now. Whatever scenario you're in, whether you're leading worshipers in from your home or from your church on a stream, just praying that all of us remember that Jesus is endlessly worthy of our worship in every setting, in every season, whether it's in front of 10 or less, or 10,000 or more, that he's worthy our most extravagant offering. And we have an opportunity to release a fragrance of worship to him now that we'll never have the chance to offer him again in heaven, because we won't be dealing with things like this. So remember that in the strangeness of all this, that there is a sweetness in your offering that has never been before, and it will never be again. So let's treasure these times and love him really well, and love the people that we're with, whether it's two or three or more. Bless you, friends.
Hey guys, it's Lydia Laird, and I just had a few quick things I wanted to say to all my worship leader friends out there. Y'all, I know the world feels crazy right now, and a lot of you guys are showing up and leading worship for an empty room, which is really defeating feeling. But I just wanted to encourage you with a story I read today in 2 Chronicles. In this story, the king of Judah basically finds out he's about to fight this huge battle, and he gets super stressed out, and he goes to God about it, and God promises that he's going to win the war for him. So he's like, great. Well, the next morning, as they're about to head out into battle, instead of putting his bravest and his strongest and his best warriors on the front lines, he chooses the singers and the worship leaders to lead Judah into battle, which is an incredible thought if you think about it. As soon as they go out into battle, it says in the Bible, when they started singing and praising, God showed up and he did what he promised he was gonna do. So as you're sitting here every Sunday leading worship, maybe feeling anxious yourself and uncertain about what the future holds, I just wanna remind you that what you are doing is imperative. Leading worship and encouraging others to join you in worship allows them to see who God is in the midst of their trials. And that is the greatest and most powerful tool against the enemy and his lies. So keep it up. Don't be disheartened. You are on the front lines for the battle of hope, and I'm with you in it. So we got this, guys. We're in this together. Love y'all.
Hey, worship leaders, Andy here from Vertical Worship. Hey, I wanted to reach out and encourage you as we are in the trenches together, putting our services online or whatever we're doing to facilitate our church bodies coming together. However that is, feels like a big inconvenience, right? And it is to many, but it's an opportunity for God. Romans 8:28 is still true. So for all the effort and the planning and the energy that's going into serving our people, remember not to take the assurance that the Spirit is going to do a great work off of the top of the list. And as worship leaders, as we invite the Spirit into living rooms and kitchens and cars, let's remember that we're giving an opportunity for families to gather together and worship together. And maybe even people who have never set foot in our churches hear the gospel for the first time and respond in salvation. So keep on, press on. God is worth it. He's worth all of this effort, and God bless you.
Hey, what's up, y'all? This is Tyler with Red Rocks Worship. Just wanted to challenge and encourage you worship leaders. I know this weekend has the potential to be really, really awkward, right? We can't meet together as a church family like we would like to. So we're recording stuff for online, recording stuff for social media. There might be a camera in your face. There might be empty chairs in front of you. I know it's weird. But let me challenge you with this. We go first, y'all. People are searching, they're wanting answers, they're uncertain. These are very uncertain times, but we have the answer, and the answer is Jesus. So this is not the time to phone it in. This is not the time to be like, I don't know about all this camera stuff, all the distractions. This is the time to stand up, to rise up with boldness, to lead with speed, and go 100. So two things, make sure you're ready to go on stage, make sure you got all your parts dialed in, everything's ready to go. But most importantly, number two, make sure that you've spent the right time with the Holy Spirit in the prayer closet, that you and the Holy Spirit are tight, you and Jesus are tight, and you're ready to go. Love y'all, talk soon.
What's up, everybody? This is Matt from I Am They. I am coming at you from my basement here, you know, just hiding from my kids for a few minutes. Just a quick word of encouragement. I don't know what you're doing, you know, this weekend. You probably don't either. Or the coming weeks, but all I know is right now is such a great opportunity for us to just connect as worship leaders to the Lord, be plugged in to our source, just get some new, fresh, just download from Him. My favorite verse right now to just meditate on is Isaiah 26. He keeps him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on Him. What better place for us to be always as worship leaders? Just right here, just eyes closed, finding Jesus, wherever He's at, whatever He's looking, however He's seeing this whole situation, what's His perspective, what's His heart, what's His anxiety level. Let's just try to connect there and stay there and encourage people to go there. You could be doing that from your basement or office space with you or your family or whoever it is. But I know it's the same. Nothing changes for us, honestly, in our spirit as worship leaders, to just begin to worship Him and tell Him who He is and adore Him for who He is, and just be reminded today, yesterday, today, and forever. He's our provider, our protector, our healer. And so, man, be encouraged today. Love you guys. God bless you.
What's up, guys? It's Logan from Kane. I always feel the temptation to have all the right answers and to know what's going on and what to do. And I want to lean on my own understanding, but God told us to do the exact opposite. People will be looking to you, but just continue to redirect them to the Lord and understand that it doesn't have to come from you, because it's going to come from Him.
Hey, I'm Madison from Kane. I'm so used to waiting till after a show or after a worship session to see how people respond, to see if it was positive. But just the fact of doing it, of worshiping Him, is all that we were created to do. And so I think in this time, God's breaking us of needing to see people's faces, to see people lift their hands, to realize that it was successful or not successful, productive or not productive. Just know that you have value as you sit. You have value as you sing, as you stand, just because God created you. And I hope that during this time we can realign what it means to be successful and what it means to be a great worship leader.
This is what I'm going to do during this weird time. I'm going to get my guitar, and I'm going to sit in a quiet place, and I'm going to just sing to Jesus and tell Him what He means to me, because for a long time we've all been in front of people, in crowds, in groups, and trying to influence people to worship, and I think that this is a great chance for us to kind of go back to the beginning of where maybe we were first called, where we first felt that pull in our spirit, like, this is what I want to do.
What you're doing, what we're doing in times like this is so important. Just don't lose hope.
We love you guys.
Hey y'all, Rhett Walker here. Just wanted to send an encouraging video to all my fellow worship leaders out there. It's time to step up and go. You know, we sing these truths every single Sunday, but we're in a time where we might be leading to empty rooms. It is all streaming online. So it's time to walk in and sing these truths that a lot of people watching on these social media platforms might not know. It's a truth of, yeah, we can be worried about where this virus is headed and what's it going to do, but we don't walk in fear as believers, because our God, who holds the whole world and this virus in his hands, is not the spirit of fear. So let's go lead these people, reminding them these truths, that we know that our God is king over all. He is not the spirit of fear, and we can still walk in joy and peace as believers. Love you guys. Go kick butt this Sunday.
Hey guys, Mark here. Just wanted to love on you and pray for you for a minute. It's been a crazy couple weeks. A lot of things are going on. There's a lot of fear, a lot of panic. And in the middle of all that, God is in complete control and God is working. We see all through the New Testament that whatever the enemy ever meant for bad, God always used for good. So when life hits a pause on us, an unexpected halt to all of our activity, we can go through the shock of the moment, but then we've got to say, all right, God, what are you doing, right? I just celebrated 5 years cancer-free, and when cancer first hit me, I didn't know what to do with it. And I had suddenly 5 weeks to lay in the bed and think. And I almost missed some things God wanted to show me. And if your kids are home, and you're home, and everybody's going to be packed in tight for a little while, ask God what he wants to do with that time. There's people around you that need help, that need hope. I'm seeing a little inward focus with this. Even walking through the airport, suddenly you don't want to be near people. We don't want to be around others. That's dangerous. I've got to be safe, but I can't walk in fear. I got to walk in wisdom. So walk in wisdom. Ask God what he's doing. He works all things together for good for those who love him and are called according to his purpose. He's at work right now. How can we, while keeping our families safe, also step in to what God is doing in this? Love you guys.
Just a quick encouragement for any worship pastors, worship leaders that are leading to empty rooms. If you're doing some virtual worship leading in this season, I just want to encourage you that even though the room feels empty, God actually can use this season to reach more people than he would have previously. So maybe rather than thinking about it feeling uncomfortable because there's like cameras instead of people, maybe it'll help us if we imagine just one person, just the one person that's going to watch this worship set, and how that's going to impact their life and how that can bless and change them. That takes some of the pressure off us in those situations and in those environments, so that way we can just focus on reaching the one.
Hey guys, it's Ellie Linebear here, and I just want to share some encouragement for this crazy, bizarre time that we are living in right now. We're all in the same boat. We're all experiencing the same emotions and anxious feelings and confusion, I think, of like what's going to happen. But I just want to encourage you that to use this time to do things that maybe you've been putting off for such a long time. Maybe it's doing a good old house clean, making bread, writing letters to friends, painting, reading that book that you've wanted to read for so long. But just use this time to slow down, rest, do things that make your soul happy, read the word, it's the best book ever. And also FaceTime. Isn't it amazing how we have FaceTime to check on loved ones and friends all over the world? I just think that's amazing. But it's going to be okay. We're in the best, safest hands, in God's hands, and it's all gonna be okay. But I hope you're doing well. Keep washing your hands. Check up on those people around you on the phone. but take care.
Hey everybody, Jacob here. Just wanted to offer a little bit of encouragement in this crazy season of quarantine and social distancing and trying to lead a church, trying to lead a congregation in the middle of all that. And maybe just a thought for everybody is just to remember when you started off and you had that first spark of wonder, the first time you strummed a G chord or the first time you played a worship pad, when it was maybe just you in your dorm room or in your bedroom or in an empty chapel, and just the wonder that you had, and just that thought of maybe one day I would actually get to lead worship, or maybe one day I would actually get to be in a worship band. And I think if you're able to tap into that place as you get up and lead on an empty, you know, for an empty auditorium or an empty sanctuary to be broadcast to people in their homes, that's a place that the Lord definitely hasn't forgotten. He's never forgotten those first moments when you had that first love for just being in His presence and leading worship just really only for yourself. And maybe the more that we're able to connect to that during the season, and maybe that's what this season is a call to reconnect to that first inspiration and that first wonder. So just things that I've been thinking about, and I just hope everybody is kind of staying safe and staying sane, and hope that thought blesses somebody.
Hey, what's up? This is Matt Marr, and just wanted to give a shout out to my fellow worship leaders. I know that right now is a very strange time for you in the sense that we're all pretty much either singing in and around cameras and not really with a group of people. And that feels like such a strange turn of events. But I want to point out two realities for you. The reality is every Sunday since the birth of the church, whenever Christians gathered in worship of God, they were participating not just in the worship, in their worship of God. The reality was they were participating in the worship of heaven. So even just as you're getting ready for your service and you're recording, and it's just like maybe some of you in a sanctuary that's empty and there's no one there, just to keep that thought in the back of your head that as you, the songs that you sing and the prayers that you're praying, you're doing it in concert with all of heaven who's worshiping God. That's the worship that we're all part of and that we're all joining into. The second is a story about an Italian nun. I shared this on Instagram earlier this week, but just this it's actually Saint Clare of Assisi. A lot of people know who Saint Francis is, but Saint Clare of Assisi was kind of like a spiritual sister of his, inspired by his life. One Christmas, she was really sick, couldn't go to church, had a vision that basically she was there, that she saw the whole thing and was able to participate in it. And the phrase that that has been with me sort of all the past 2 weeks is that prayer and worship turns walls into windows. So a lot of people right now are faced with moments and events that are happening that feel like a wall kind of coming up in front of them. And worship has the ability for us to kind of see with God's perspective right through it and participate in the worship of heaven. So two thoughts for you as you head into the weekend. Thanks so much for what you do, and we'll see you at Essential Worship. God bless.
Hey friends, just wanted to send you something that's been really encouraging to me in this season, and that is just knowing that God is creating room, and that sometimes He does that by adding and sometimes He does it by taking away. But the beautiful thing about God is every time He takes something away, it still is an addition, you know? I really can feel that He's doing something so new in this season, and the delay for me would be to keep trying to like force the old instead of being willing to let it go and just say, God, what would you have me do? You know, it's so easy in a time in history when we're so connected by social media to just keep doing the same things and like putting it out through a different outlet. But I would encourage you in this season that even though this is on social media, I'm actually trying to stay pretty far away from social media and just lean into God and use this time as an upper room experience for me and my husband. That's been so encouraging to us, to the point where we felt like we've got these new downloads from God. And so I'd encourage you, it's available to everybody. It's available to you, and you can have it firsthand instead of getting it like secondhand from somebody else. So why don't you switch off social media and just go and spend some time with God.